What's going on? What's going on in this big old world? What's going on in the world today? I want you to know that I'm your love. When you walk out that door, don't go away. Please don't go. I'm begging you to stay. If you leave, at least in my lifetime, I had one dream come true. I was blessed to be loved by someone as wonderful as you. Please don't go away, please don't go. Don't go. I'm begging you to stay. I'll turn it down a little bit. You need it down? Probably on 74.5 since we've been gone. We're on 73 now. It's 2 degrees higher. I set mine up to 77. You know, and then when I get home, I turn it down. That's how I do it. I stay on the ground. Well, okay. You're right, I guess. Come alive tonight.
cloudy day in a heavy downpour. Thought he passed his own shadow by the backstage door. Like a truck through the back. The next day in the rain. And that one guitar
made his whole life change.
Now he needs to be the right.
Gotta keep on working. Don't let it put me on top. Be a jukebox. The world is hard and in line. Jukebox hero.
We're going. My nephew, mama. Hope you done okay. Tell her I said hi. Doing okay.
You gotta keep it rocking. You just can't stop. Gotta keep on rocking. That morning, I'm gonna
be on top. To be a jukebox. Hero, stars in his eyes.
He's a jukebox hero. Jukebox hero.
Got stars in his eyes.
He's a jukebox hero. Jukebox hero.
Oh, Andrea, you out there? You out there, Andrea?
Oh, my.
Hey, I'm in the studio, bro.
I'm in the studio.
I'm in the studio.
Oh, God, this song, of course.
Of course.
I ain't put it on this song. I ain't been that listening that much. Apparently, listening to your favorite song on a stream. You got to do with something.
I was locked up on
controversial.
Ain't
get to see my nephews. Ain't trying to use that as an excuse.
Well, you know, he been listening to the song Murder on My Mind and singing it.
Everybody acting suspicious. Might probably say that.
Well, what do you want us to do about this?
When I'm all alone in my
cell,
grab
him out of there.
And all that smoke is dead loud.
Let me
don't pass me no mention. And I'm gonna smoke all of my pain away.
That
that's
sound
the
like?
Only thing that gon' hit it. I don't understand you women who go around pretending as if they really fuck with me. So I love them all from a distance. Cause the same bitch
so
she down the ride be the main one who tricking.
You'd be mad at me because I said something about you is incorrect. Minuscule and fucking petty. But no, you missed about that more than you saying you're going to wring my fucking neck.
I got murder on my mind.
Wasn't I will, I might, I could, it was.
I got murder on my
mind.
I got murder on my mind.
It was a
yellow tape around his body.
You don't get more direct threatening than that.
His
if I got on here tonight and said to any of them fucks, whether they're girls or themselves, anything, their grandparents, not anything like that, any of them are about any of that, I'd have to break their mind.
He grabbed me by my hands and said he was afraid to die. I told him it's too late, my friend, it's time to say goodbye. And he died inside.
And they probably
my
fight
own
over which one of them has to put it to the police so they get the most cash out.
Morning, I got murder on my mind. AK-47
back to living.
Boston, I don't know what he was in. hate and try to knock me off my grind.
No matter off.
But I can't let them do it. I got murder on my mind, bitch. I got murder on my mind.
And I always say it all. Legally, yeah. And then they come back with it.
But the bitch can be a ring.
They're trying to blame me. They think they can trigger me into doing something I regret. Nah.
I got murder on my mind.
Maybe a year ago. But some of you were acting more covert. Not now.
Bitch, I'm a murderer.
Yes.
I might just kill the boy. Don't want to kill the boy. Make him say he won't beat me. Gonna free the boy.
Free the boy.
I'm feeling so red. I might dip his ass in it and spill
the boy.
Murder on my mind. Oh, 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 oh. I got murder on my mind. I got murder on my mind. I got murder on my mind. Wake up in the morning. I got murder on my mind. AK-47s, Mac 11, lots of nines, and all these pussy niggas hating, trying to knock me off my mind. But I can't let them do it. I got murder on my mind, bitch. I got murder on my mind.
I got murder on my mind.
Young nigga world, bitch.
Bitch. Don't read a boy.
Hey.
Here, I'll listen to it about 5 more times, maybe though. So then they can try to use it.
Be like, see, he's fucking, he's a rage. He's a rough. Now let's check 51 fidget.
Pieces of shit. Alive, motherfucker. All last a half year, we was the group that fucking, oh,
you snitch, you dunny, the snitch, you square, the snitch, you square. Now we sending somebody who ain't got relevance in our group that much, so he gotta put in that work. That's why we sent JR and Polly, of course, MC and Fusion, they put in the works of the work of the work, you know, but they just had to go to make sure JR and Polly didn't fucking goof it up.
Motherfucker, I see y'all. I see what you're doing. I know what you're doing. Like, you could try that shit till you blew in the face, but I don't have to regularly watch your shows or try to keep up with you to fucking know what you're doing. I stay in contact with people.
She told me that I'm not enough.
Yeah.
She left me with a broken heart.
Oh my God.
She fooled me twice and it's all my fault.
Oh, by the way, I saw somebody that knows someone my ex-wife had dated. I bumped into him. A significant other. And I was like, hey, you know, you remember my ex-wife? She's like, yeah. She's like, yeah. I was like, I ran this down to her. I was like, she's like, man, fuck. She's like, fuck her. She's like, she's crazy. She's like, what makes you say that? I said to her, she said, Jeremy had to quit. See, she had dated this guy, I don't know, but Jeremy and some others. And the only reason I know that is because, you know, we live in a small area and a lot of people have each other on Facebook. So I actually had him as a mutual friend, even though we weren't friends. And I was like, yeah, I knew she dated him. Okay. And she's like, yeah, she cried. I was like, man, she crazy. She got all these weird ideas. So I was like, let me guess. She tried to get him to stop eating meat and stuff. She said, yes. I was like, yeah. I was like, oh. You know, she got that from me.
She's like, huh? I was like, yeah, you know, I introduced her to all that healthy living type stuff. I mean, I'm sure she's heard of it before. Everybody's heard of vegetarian stuff, but when she came into my life, she was on antipsychotics and all that other shit. And the person was like, she should have stayed on them. So take your crazy lying ass, Kayla, and go the fuck on down the road. Because I done heard that the Workiverse is bad, that you didn't use that money you got on a divorce. I guess they was hoping that, what'd you guys think by giving her money for a divorce, hoping that she'd use it for that purpose? Did you seriously consider that she was going to fucking do it? And okay, let's say she did it. Let's say she took your money and she was above board. Forget the fact that none of you know this woman personally at all. But you're just taking her side because you hate me. All right. And she runs off with it. Don't get the divorce because I hadn't been served. Y'all hadn't heard anything about it. That's why they're mad. These motherfuckers probably thought that I'm purposely avoiding, like, wanting to divorce her or something like that. Maybe she fed to them that I'm still fucking hung up over her. Who knows? But I've been over that bitch for years now. Yeah, I don't like it. It's somebody that it's my first wife. It's the first person I married in my lifetimes. So no, I didn't like it or nothing. But you know, I mean, fuck. Send her another $500 because I want her to divorce me, please. Yeah. Maybe if you send her $500 for her fucking addiction or whatever habit she's probably actually got going on, and another $500 for the divorce, maybe she'll think then she'll do it. Fucking idiots. I mean, that is a course that I wasn't lied to. Now they're gonna say right now, well, don't nobody let him know. Quick, leading messages that shows that he, you know. But that's exactly what I got told. Yeah. That they sent her $500 and they're mad because she has to fucking use it.
Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you love
me. Let's see who says Workiverse wrong, man.
I don't want for them to miss me. I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story.
I believe it.
Different with me.
Could be alive, God's but hell, I believe it.
God's plan.
I hope it's like times I'm on a hill.
I feel good sometimes I don't.
I don't. Hey. Yo.
I finesse down Western Road. Hey, next. Might go down to G-O-D.
G-O-D.
I go hard on Southside G.
I make sure that there's no side eat.
And still.
Bad things.
It's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish and they wish
on me. Bad things.
It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Yeah. Hey. She said, do you love me? I tell her only
hardly.
I only love my bed and my mom. I'm sorry. 50 dub, I even got it tatted
on me.
81, they'll bring the crashes to the party.
And you know me.
Turn the 02 into the 03. Without 40, Ollie, Debbie, know me. Imagine if I never met the broskies.
God's plan. God's plan.
I can't do this on my own. Hey, nope. Someone watching it close. Yep,
close.
I've been me since Scarlet Road. Hey, bro. Hey, might go down as G-O-D. Yep, wait. I go hard on Southside G. Hey, wait.
I make sure that Northside E.
Yeah. And still.
Bad things.
It's a lot of bad things that they wish and wish and wish and wish and wish and wish on me. Yeah. Yeah. Bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 they wish on me. Yeah.
that have been away. Haven't changed, had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. Told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. I said, the boys are back in town. You know that chick that used to dance a lot? Every night she'd be on the floor shaking what she'd got. Man, when I tell you she was cool, she was red hot. I mean she was steaming. And that time over at Johnny's place, well, this chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. If that chick don't wanna know, forget her. The boys are back in town, the boys are back in town. I said, the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town. The boys are back in town.
I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.
I get those goosebumps every time.
I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. 713 to the 281, yeah, I'm riding. Why they on me? Why they on me? I'm flying, zipping low key. I'm zipping low key in Onyx, find a rider. When I pull it up right beside you, pop star Lil Mariah. When I take skit game mileage, throw a stack on the Bible. Never Snapchat or took Molly. She fall through plenty, her and all her guineas. Yeah, we at the top, so right there off Doheny. Yeah, oh no, I can't fuck with y'all. Yeah, when I'm with my squad, I cannot do no wrong. Yeah, saucemen in the city, don't get misinformed. Yeah, they gon' pull up on you. Yeah, we gon' do some things you can't relate. Yeah, cause we from a place you cannot stay. Or you can't go, or I don't know. Or back the fuck up off me. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time.
I wanna press my like, yeah. I wanna press my. I wanna agree like, I wanna be like, I wanna press my line, yeah. I wanna take that right, yeah. I'm gonna press my line. I wanna agree like, I wanna be like, I wanna press my. Mama dear, spare your feelings, I'm reliving moments, feeling more residual. I can buy the building, burn the building, take your bitch, rebuild the building just to fuck some more.
I can justify my love for ya and touch the sky, forgot to stop debating war.
Put the pussy on the pedestal. Put the pussy on the high hoops. That pussy to die for. That pussy to die for.
Need a pipe or pick the peppers. I can pick your brain and put your heart together. We depart the shady parts and party hard. The diamond shook the cool forever. My best shot just might shoot forever. Like
I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind. You make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments. I'm way too dumb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.
I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich. Throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time.
Young money. Yeah. So. I tell her, knock out and pop that pussy for a real nigga. I already know that life is deep, but I still dig her. Niggas is jealous, but really I could care less. I'm in Hell's Kitchen with an apron and a headnet. Devil on my shoulders. The Lord is my witness, so on my Libra scale, I'm weighing sins and forgiveness. What goes around comes around like a hula hoop. Karma is a bitch, well, just make sure that bitch is beautiful. Life on the edge, I'm dangling my feet. I tried to pay attention, but attention paid me. Haters can't see me. Nosebleed seats, and today I went shopping, and talk is still cheap. I rock to the beat of my drum set. I've been at the top for a while, and I ain't jumped yet. But I'm Ray Charles to the bullshit, and I jump up on that dick and do a full split.
She just started to pop it for a nigga, and look back and tell me, baby, it's real. And I say I ain't doubt you for a second. I squeeze it and I can tell how I feel. I wish we could take off and go anywhere but here, baby, you know the deal. And she bad, so maybe she won't, but shit, then again, maybe she will. Yeah, do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now. She will, yeah, do it for the realest niggas in the fucking game right now.
Ain't nobody trouble me, ain't nobody trouble the sky. Ain't nobody trouble, man, I'm taking this spot. God, you niggas are sick.
Don't you open up that window. Don't you let out that antidote. Yeah. Popping pills is all we know. Inhales is all we know. Don't go through the front though. It's no key at the night show. So don't you open up that window. Don't you let out the antidote. Yeah. We party on a Sunday. Do it all again on Monday. Spent the check on a weekend. Oh my God. I might do it all again.
That's bullshit.
I just hit a 3-peat. Fuck 3 hoes I met this week. I don't do no old hoes. My nigga, that's a no-no. She just want the gold though. I just want the narrow. Who that at the front though? If it's the fans, oh no, no, no. Don't you open up that window. Don't you let out that antidote. Popping pills is all we know. Inhales is all we know. Don't go through the front though. It's low key at the night show. Anything happened at the night show. Everything happened at the night show. Ooh, at the night show. Anything happened at the night show. Ooh, at the night show. Ooh, your bitch not at home, she at the night show. Ooh, fucking right, ho. Ooh, had to catch a flight for the night show. Ooh, let's get bite though. Bottles got us right though. We ain't sipping light, no. I ain't got no time though. Only got one night though. We can do it twice though. It's lit.
At the night show. 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 Everything you have at the night show. Ooh, at the night show.
Stack it up, daddy, nigga, nigga. You know you gotta go get it, my nigga. They hating, they thinking, they waiting. Don't be mistaken, we dying to stand. Thought I'm on fire, they thinking I'm safe. Calling me crazy on different occasions. Kicking the cameraman off of my stations. Cause I don't like ice having my angles. I'm overboard and I'm over impatient. Up on my niggas and knees, cause my agents dealing with motion that's more complicated. Like these two bitches that might be related. Each time you got one, and you bump it like a number one. It's late now, you got a late show. If you wanna roll, I got a place where
popping pills is all we know. Inhales is all we know. Don't go through the front though. It's low key at the night show. So don't you open up that window.
I'm swagging on you. I'm balling, I have a song on you. Watch out, yeah. I smash out, yeah. I'm spending all my fucking pay. I got me some braids and I got me some hoes. Started rocking the sleeve, I can't buy with no drawers. You know how I do it, can close on my toes. Oh. I ain't rich yet, but you know I ain't broke. So if I see it, I get back from the store. I'm with some white girls and they love them to coke. Like they OT. Double OT, like I'm KD, smoking OG. And you know me, my 2-3s and my gold tee. Bitch, you're smiling, bitch, you see me from the nosebleed. I'm the new 3, and I change that to my new D. Might I have a song? When I started balling, I was young. You gon' think about me when I'm gone. I need that money, ring I never want. I want
sussing on you.
I'm swagging.
Oh.
I'm balling.
Watch out, yeah.
Spending on my fucking face. Cigarettes in the hand, man. Comma commas in my head, man. Slum door, like a dead man. Ready, I'm dead, but my bread, man. I'm
answering the question.
Lay sub,
learn a lesson. I thought you'd sit in the door. Since I woke up this morning, man, I don't have any. I got real. Years ago, but I'm having some issues with that again. I don't know why I slept. I hardly ever sleep. I must have fallen asleep in a weird way.
Watch out, yeah, smash out, okay, rehab. Spending on my fucking face.
Well, yeah, there's an office there. They remember she met us. I'll call Miss White, and because I need to ask her if she can still help me. In the direction of helping me with getting a job in lobby. Because the longer I go without getting my first job, it's going to be harder and harder than I do for now. Stop smoking 30 days from now. I could work for lobby. Probably
probably sooner if I use that cleanse. So I didn't use that cleanse. I'm bad at fucking procrastinating shit.
I can spit some. I'm a smoke, got a bird, I would drink a potato, one molly water. So, but my bitches ain't sober.
Yeah, but she's gonna be. I don't know. The difference is I have. Well, I got health issues, and I don't know if I'll rehab. I don't know all of what they help with. That's why I'm saying she's a mom. And she's already entitled to just about everything, and I just don't know if I'll work that out. But I'll get it for. I'll get that merciful. Hell, these assholes online, they would. No, if these people online that nobody's ever decided to invest here, yeah, they had just called just 2 weeks before, all that would have been wasted. That money would have been non-refundable. I wouldn't have graduated. Yeah, I know. We handled the medicine issue. Thank God for that. Getting taken down on that little by little. I think I'm gonna like it. Just taking Ativan or taking nothing. But, you know, I'll work with that. You got somebody that beeped up. The fuck does this dude want? He always wanted to come up here. Dude, you act like I had no idea you was involved in all that hip-hop bullshit the other night.
I wasn't involved with it. I didn't talk to them behind the scenes.
Come on, man. Damn, man, you're good. All you motherfuckers are gatekeeping characters.
Dude, I put it on my son. You can ask Fusion. You can ask MC. He did text me and ask me.
You put it on your son. You ain't working with them or cool with them in the slightest.
I mean, I'm friends with Fusion and Filthy and MC. Yeah, I've always been friends with them. But no, I'm not working first. I don't go.
Dude,
with
I should drop. I should kick you from my panel right now. I don't want to be cool or talk to anybody that considers themselves friends with those assholes. Don't you understand that?
Yeah, but I'm not like participating in any harm to you.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm sure that was all 110. Oh, yeah, I know you all hope that. You just are going to try to make it as hard as you fucking can or fucking throw in some shit or whatever you can possibly maneuver.
You seem a little tense, you know, today. As long as
I squirm. Oh, I'm tense. Yeah, I woke up. I pinched a nerve in my hand. I'm not doing too great, but I'm above ground, 6 feet above. I'm fine. I'm fine. I ain't got shit to worry about.
How'd you pick your hand?
We're gonna be moving brownies training to in person. He's hitting a stubborn spot, and he's gonna need more than just positive reinforcement methods. I think I'll listen to somebody that trains canines for police and people more than I would a fucking app or some vet tech. I mean, don't get me wrong. Anyone that wants to use a good pup for basic training and shit, go ahead. But I think they kind of lied to me a little bit when they said they'd help me and be able to do what I wanted to do. Or maybe they didn't lie, but they thought they could. You know,
that's what most people do nowadays, man. Sell dreams.
Well, that's not a dream. I just, you know, I'm trying to get my dog trained. And I mean, I went through basic obedience. And while we were going through basic obedience, well, I decided I wanted him to be, to talk with my old psychiatrist and was going to have him be a PSD since he was an ESA and take it up a step further. And, they were like, yeah, we can help facilitate that because you can self-train him and all that. Okay, all right, well, that's what I'll do. But as I've done some research and talked to this other guy that uses positive reinforcement, but also, like, e-collar,
people want to call them shock collars, but I held this thing in my hand when I got it in the mail a while ago. I cranked that bitch up halfway, and it can only go up another, 50 increments. It's exactly like a TENS unit. Now, yeah, is it comfortable?
It just kind of surprises me.
Is it? It's not it's not, and they can't train, but the other guy, he knows how to incorporate stuff. Their organization just, they're against that. So they're not, since he's stubborn, I think he could use it, They talk about a risk that some dogs can have an adverse reaction to it, but I don't think he will. As long as I do it sensitive, I just need to use it to like get him, because he don't want to. Sometimes like he don't want to lay down or nothing, like, or he don't, he don't want to respond, like he takes being told 2, 3, 4 times to respond, and that's not optimal. Like, I ought to be able to tell him, and at the most, I might have to wait a second, but he should, respond. Like, I shouldn't have to go, hey, you're getting stubborn.
Right. Hey, I'm just relaying the message. MC just texted me and asked if he would unblock him.
No. I get no. See, when you do stuff like that, man, you're,
dude, what do you expect? I jump up on panel and then they start texting me, hey, asking them what.
Yeah, but you're risking your spot on the panel just by doing that, because don't you know that's how I first started all this shit? Slowly, I had people that were mods that were in their group I didn't know that were acting nice to my face 100% of the time, like wacky at first, and then later on. He comes out and stuff, and as they come out more and more of them get blocked, there's one person like you or something that hadn't really went there with me, maybe, so they use y'all because they know I'm not gonna have a reason, or if I do come at you, you're gonna be like, well, why are you attacking me? I'm not that, like, dude, I'm so past that shit. That's so obvious.
Well, that's why I like, out on us.
When you're up here on a panel with them, and Fusion and MC play fighted like that the other night, yes, the fuck I can.
Well, I didn't know they was play fighting.
You knew it. They were play fighting.
I did not. I thought MC and
that's the whole part of trolling.
Trouble in Paradise.
That's not.
Well, if they were trolling, they got me too.
Yeah, MC's gonna come on my panel fully doxed and fucking try to point towards their great leader, Filthy, and try to point me in a way to get his information, and legitimately in front of Fusion. They sold it well at first. I'll give them that. But, as I was on there, I was like, no.
Well, for all we know, it could be true. Maybe they're just trying to see if you'll do it. Because, he did sell whatever. Filthy won that ticket.
I know he did. I remember hearing. I remember seeing that story, but just like I thought,
Donald Candy Ball.
I saw in the chat, Donald didn't send it to Filthy. He sent it to Rick. I didn't think Rick at first, but when I saw it in the chat, that's exactly how I was thinking. I was like, well, he might have sent it to an address or P.O. box that somebody set up, Moses or somebody. You don't know who he sent it to. And then they forwarded it, because ain't nobody – Filthy's not going to do that. Not somebody who they was just making fun of and calling a locale not but 2, 3 months beforehand. And they're not going to pull a rookie mistake like that. Like, I may have been a little naive to how this locale and trolling and shit worked, but I did study history, and I love history, and I know how all the banking side and both sides of every war and shit. I'm not stupid to how strategy works in wars and shit. I know how it works. I ain't gonna leave a trail that easy.
I don't know, man.
That's why he assumed that dude Walters. But I tell you this, Filthy, you better hope that you are Walter or a friend of Walter's, because Walter's been reached out by somebody, whoever that, dude, that Facebook
that
is.
That Walter guy is a homosexual truck driver.
Hey, that has that's
nothing
fine
to do with Phil.
But guess what, though? That homosexual truck driver's already been informed that he's been impersonated as him, blamed as him, the guy assumed his identity, pretended to.
Well, Filthy can't help they called him Walter. It's like he can't help they called him the barbecue guy.
But he lied and said he was.
He never said he was. He just went along with it.
Yes, he did. He's an come on now.
You gotta say that's good strategy.
He just went along with it as strategy. Yeah, well, let's see whose real legal name feels about that strategy, because they could take some action on that. You know, I'll just get more and more heat on him to the point that he'll eventually get found out. I ain't gonna pay Donald nothing or nobody.
Maybe
you
not.
Motherfuckers
we'll
ain't getting, you motherfuckers ain't getting any more of my money. Whoever got that 400, I hope you sent it and shoved it up your nose or whatever, because you know, get another 400. Tried to impersonate that guy down in Texas. I mean, they're reckless. I mean, you know, how are you gonna just pick some random person's identity and assume it and say, you know, because, you know, he put a fucking clown wig on that thing and had it on a display picture. He said, "I'm Walter Allen," I don't know how many times when people confronted him or were saying, "What's his name, bitch," or whatever, you know. So, I mean, I don't know how you don't call that in person, you know, assuming his identity. And how can he do that and preach about doxing?
I haven't really heard him preach about doxing.
Because, yeah, he has. They talk about, that's one of their main things they wanted to bring up about everybody. Ian doxed this person. She doxed them. They doxed them. Yeah, after they doxed the first. In most situations, sometimes the other person did dox them first. I didn't dox AD first. I didn't dox him still. Well, you know, I didn't dox him again first. He doxed me. He was cool with letting me know. He knew what my address was. Because, hell, he'd done been in plenty of chats where he'd seen him dox it before.
Yeah.
I told him, and he knows Haytime, Missouri is me, and he may not know the exact address, but I'm sure once he sees that Haytime there, he knows it's me. Everybody knows I live in Haytime. Ooh, okay. You motherfuckers y'all show up here. All I can tell you is to visit the local attractions, which are none, but you're not invited here. Who says we're going to live here forever? You know, I actually got asked something here recently. And I gotten reached out by somebody that, well, let's just say it's state funded, because it's part of the therapy, the place I go to. They do state funding stuff. They have resources. So I've made a report to them. And since it's, and because it, when I, after it, man, I sat there and spent about probably 45 minutes explaining this shit. I mean, really trying to explain it detailed and not wash over anything I might have done wrong or anything. Like, I was open about stuff I did that was naive and stuff. They said, well, still with all that, like, you know, are you, do you feel safe? You know, I was like, no, not really. You know, so that's enough for them to turn that in on my behalf, you know, so it's not me reporting it to the local police. And I gave a few the names that I had in there, so
yeah,
they get contacted by anybody, they get contacted. I've been telling them.
Maybe you can get Seepers help now. They're going at him hard over there on Fusion's panel.
I'm convinced that JR is ran, if not me, some people through his little NICS tool, He's not allowed to do that unless he's selling a firearm, and there's got to be a penalty if you can prove that. All I'd have to do is know his business's name and make a report, and they check his system, because I'm sure it keeps logs of the research he does. And if he ain't got a corresponding firearm record sale and inventory and all that that was gone with a serial number and everything, he's going to have to explain why the fuck he's got people background checks ran. And I don't think you want to do that, JR. So why don't you fucking back off, dude? Just for all purposes. Because I know you and Paula right now are on the outs with people. That's why y'all was both up here and tried to come up here on my panel.
Give me 1 second, Square. My mom's talking to me.
I can't remember the previous day. Are you kidding me? Get the fuck out of here. Do I have a plan, Carrie? I'm not drugging Brownie. No, I just said he's getting stubborn. Where am I going to live? Why are you, don't ask me that. Carrie, don't ask me questions like that. I'll ban you quick.
All right, my bad.
Don't ask me questions about my life, Carrie, all right? Because I said it clearly the other day. That was the last time I was given the update. I got in. I got treatment and everything, and that's all you need to know to finish my taper. I'm not giving you any more health information. I'm not sharing any more about my life.
Gosh.
I'm not doing any of that. How are you going to sit here and be like, oh, what are you going to do if Grampy goes into assisted living? What the fuck do you think I'm here for? You think I sit in my bed all day? I think these people think I really sit in my bed all fucking day long. And if that's the case, why ain't I been live today? Oh, I don't know. Maybe because I ain't been home. Maybe because I had shit to do. Maybe I was working. You fucking know.
Don't let them get to you, Square.
I seen Dagburn showed.
I hadn't seen that guy in a minute.
Well, he posted a community post of Danny back in the day apologizing to me and him. What's funny though is he's got my name listed first in the apology, and I'm like, "Your post," because he was mainly talking about me, and it's an instance where, you know, Danny was. I mean, at that point in time, I think Dagburn was on his positive gang, like the PBG. I think that was before the lawsuits and stuff and everything. And when him and Tamara, or when Tamara and Patty and all them were all cool. And so it was back in that time, he wasn't getting that fucked with. I mean, he'd been getting fucked with the whole time, but he wasn't getting, like, it didn't heat up, you know, with all the stuff that Miss Patty and all that. So back then, that's why he had me titled first, because he used me and then he used Dagburn as a backup. You know, because he was apologizing to both of us because we had both been done wrong. But no, the reason why I said my name being first significant and Johnny posting that, because Johnny said specifically your last in his live, he's like,
man, I don't need to for you to tell your story or once you come up here. It ain't got nothing to do with me at all. It ain't got no comparison, nothing relevant. Well, how much more relevant do you call it when a guy titles you in both of the titles and apologizes for fucking joining in with shit? I mean.
Yeah, I put y'all in the same boat, sure.
And that's what I told Johnny. I left him a comment today. He got it and saw it, or he didn't. But it just said straight up, I was like, dude, I was like, I'll say it again. I apologize for the shit last year. But, you know, I wouldn't have made any videos or criticized you here recently or talked any shit if you had just, you know, you could have just been a little nicer or something. Like, you didn't have to, like I said, because it is relevant. So you tried to blow me off and say shit didn't even mean. You should have just been straight up like, no, I'm not going to have it here because I don't want Fusion and them going back on me any harder or putting more energy in or anything. Because that's basically the main reason he done that. He just didn't want to add to the people anymore that he's fucking with. Because he's went back and forth with trying to get Fusion to stop talking about him and making a deal with him and shit. I mean, I guess they think I don't remember those times or anything, but I do. I've been around since. No, but that's what I mean. But at the time, he was cool with him because he went on the panel and said, "Work you burst strong. What you gonna do now, Square?" That's exactly what he said.
Well, there was times that you went on the panel with us.
I never went on the panel and said, "Work you burst strong. What you gonna do now, blank?" Whether you fill in Andrea, Army, Books, whoever. I've never done that. You can't find the clip. And I'll pay you $100.
I'm pretty sure you did, Square, when you were being buddy with them. I wasn't in there at the time.
Even those times where the first buddy tro and then the later ones, which they'll still argue and say I had no idea about, got tricked, which I knew just like last night. I didn't really believe all that shit. And I thought something was up the whole time. I mean, yeah, sometimes some of their shit was convincing, sure. And, you know, at times, like, you go back and forth with thoughts like that if you're thinking from all aspects. But, I don't know. I just don't know where I'm going. I just don't know what Dagburn's thing. Like what gets me about him now is how do I say this? I don't want to say it and they'd be like, oh, but it's like he's pulling the same shit that everybody else is doing.
You should pull up Fusion's chat and look at what's going down over there. They're going super hard. Yeah, well,
just tell me about it.
I mean, I really don't know all about what. So apparently, some shit in the back streets between Seeker and Wade. Filthy called them both out and called them both locals. And now Seeker's on the panel, saying his brother works for the NSA and he's going to do this and that. All kinds of shit.
That's dumb. National Security Agency, huh? He couldn't think of a more fucking better, like, yeah, pick the fucking agency that's got the most fucking, like, I mean, I guess that is a little bit better than trying to say, like, CIA, but still, the NSA, really? Those are the people that monitor and listen in on shit.
He's an Edward Snowden.
Yeah, those are Edward Snowden people. Those are fucking hackers and fucking shit. So you got a brother in there? Okay. I'm sure he don't appreciate if he is in there and has a job, you fucking risking it by threatening and saying you can get him to do shit. So I hope he ain't doxxed or anything, because if he is and they know who his brother is and his brother did work at the NSA, well, that ain't
If he ain't doxxed, he will be soon. I bet you that.
Yeah. And his whole fucking family, including any brother. So, yeah, just a disclaimer for everyone out there. If you got somebody who works in the government, I would never use them as a threat, you know. Unless they told you that they're so big that you can. They won't be touched.
Get somebody fired.
I mean, no, but I mean, shit, if it's like Hunter Biden's son or, you know, somebody that they think won't is untouchable, I mean, I guess they can do what they want. But,
I don't think they'll be scared of him one bit. I think dude's full of shit myself.
People think that I'm against the Constitution. You know, they tried to say and act like I'm against free speech and all that for trying to get these fucking trolls out and ban them because they're doing bullshit. But I'm not. I'm a big believer in liberty. I'd say I'm more a believer in liberty than any of these fucks that have tried to false snitch or like JR trying to get me to actively break a law when I know I can't. Because he can try to trigger my ego or something, he thinks he can. Like, I mean, liberty is having the ability to do the wrong thing, but choosing to do the right, but choosing to rather, you know, use your freedom and choice for something better or something that don't affect or harm anybody else. You can't say any of these people are using their liberty or freedom. You know, I mean, half the time they're on a live fucking sitting at a TV screen or something watching someone else's live panel while they're talking about just one of us. When I say us, I mean, like, I don't know what Seeker's done online. What can they say that I've done on here, really? It's so horrible. I got angry and wished something close to death on a few people one time, cancer specifically, because they had went behind my back and was talking shit on me on a panel and I got triggered. Yeah,
wasn't
I
it
did
butt
that.
Cancer?
No.
Didn't he say butt cancer?
It might have been prostate. don't get me wrong. I mean, at first I didn't feel bad or nothing, no. And I only laughed because he said, but I'm not laughing at cancer. But no, I mean, you know, I can sit here like a big boy and say, I was wrong. I fucking did wrong in that. So, I mean, other than that, what else? Oh, some people's names accidentally got seen from fucking my screaming fuck ups. Yeah, okay. And from some things I posted. Yeah, and I showed yours twice. I showed Sugar Nova's, I think. Well, no, there were a few people that accidentally got doxxed, and probably people would say that I really legitimately doxxed, and I don't even say they got doxxed, but because it's just a name, technically being doxxed, someone taking your whole shit, like the definition is someone putting your name, DOB, all that, in one easy, convenient to look spot. MC tried to argue, but all you need is a name, and people can use it and find stuff, so technically that's a dox. All right, if you want to call it a dox, I call it a small mini dox, whatever. We'll split in hers. But I mean, I haven't pulled my junk out. I ain't showed my asshole like books. I haven't done anything like that.
I hope you never do, Square. I hope you never do.
I wouldn't do that, one, period. But two, I certainly wouldn't do it when I got all these people hyper fixating on me and just itching to try to maybe see if I break a law or anything they can do to fucking cause me pain. You know, fuck no. Wow, when Grampy dies in a year or less. Who said anything about that? The Queen of England lived to be over 100. Yeah, she had access to probably the best drugs and shit, but still, yeah, that shit don't fucking
preserve somebody 100%. You know, a lot of it's just genetics and fucking. Well, what happened then? If she shed her skin suit because it was time to fucking shed it and it was falling apart, where'd she go, huh?
It was time to go home.
She just. I mean, that if you're David Icke, that's what you can believe. They actually literally believe that our world leaders are basically reptilian, human hybrids, and the body is like a vehicle that they're driving, and when it gets worn out, they just simply get out of it and go to another famous person or person that's being groomed for politics, and the next thing you know, that person's the fucking chairman of the Federal Reserve. If you're David Icke, you know, Ben Bernanke,
all kinds of times,
fucking Ben Bernanke, you can't say that motherfucker wasn't a lizard. Oh, Ben Bernanke. Oh, I got something funny we can watch on YouTube. I actually, I cooked Kayla dinner, fixed her dinner at her house one night, and we sat down and we watched this. Hold on.
Damn, it's true. Yeah, it was killing my battery.
It was funny running into that girl earlier, because
we couldn't really hear what you were saying about that because you had music blasting. Anything you said while that music was blasting, we didn't understand.
Okay. I ran into someone that I know who is with somebody that was with my wife for a short period of time. After, right. You know, I'm talking about years after we had separated. Like, right. Not, you know, so I ain't got no issue or ever had no issue because of it or felt no type of way. Well, they were dating, and then all of a sudden I knew it was over. And I never knew why, but I saw this girl today who is engaged or married to the dude now. And she's a blackjack dealer, actually. Shit, I probably shouldn't have said that. Fuck it. Anyway, I was trying to ask her. I was like, you remember my ex? What? She's like, Lord, yes. I said, I'm not trying to, you know, come at you no type of way or anything. I was like, you mind telling me, like, what the fuck caused her and Jeremy to split, you know? Because she dated this dude named Jeremy. Since I already revealed the blackjack dealer thing, I can go ahead and I don't mind saying his first name. Dude's name's Jeremy. Anyways, but don't fuck with Jeremy. Even she admitted, like, you know, that she was crazy. I was like, I told her that about these people that paid her, because from what I've been told, now I don't know if it's true, but from what I've been told, that the war heroes gave her some money, apparently. You know, well, I knew they gave her money for that fucking interview, but apparently I was told she was given some money to specifically, like, handle the divorce.
I don't know about all that.
And they've been waiting for me to get the papers and make a live about it, and they haven't came, you know, because she ain't filed them. If she filed them, I'd gladly sign them.
I'd want to too.
I mean, you know, I don't want to. As it stands, if I, you know, well. I protected my any assets or insurance I got from her, but still, I just don't want to stay married to her. But I'm a cheap bastard, I ain't gonna lie, and that's why I never went for the divorce. I've actually tried to figure out how to do it, and I've been told, oh, you could just file it in the paper, and you don't get a response; it happens automatically. But nobody ever told me how to get that done. You know,
dog. I don't even read the paper or get the paper, so I, you know. But I had a piece of paper around my house that maybe it's, it was around here, and it dealt with, it was a handout from thing when I went to the career center here a while back to update and print off my resumes and stuff and give them my transcript for school. They had seen something. Oh, no, it was at the courthouse. It was when I went to try to get a background check myself. And here it is. For those seeking information about filing your own pro se divorce, the Supreme Court on December 23rd, 2008, by order approved of the family law forms required, Rule 88.09 pro se family litigants. This order becomes effective on April 1st. Any party filing a divorce must use the following procedures on the Missouri Judiciary webpage. The approved forms are available in a package on the link representing yourself website at selfrepresent.mo.gov. 88.09 also requires every party not represented by counsel to complete a litigant awareness program. You must print the certificate upon completion and attach it with your petition and filing fees. The forms may be completed online and printed on paper. The following forms are available: certificate of dissolution, petition of dissolution, statement of property, notice of hearing, judgment of dissolution, respondent's answer, litigant awareness program, filing fee $102.50. Divorce kits or forms purchased from office supply stores or obtained from other sources will not be accepted. I think I'll finally get the ball rolling on that.
Yeah, I would if I was you.
Not knowing them, they'll probably tell her now. Contest it, contest it. She wouldn't contest it. I don't care what y'all pay her. I don't know on what ground she would contest it either, considering she left me.
Right.
Yeah. She cheated on me. See, I only thought it was loud in my ear, but is that so loud y'all can't hear me?
It's lower than you are, but the pitch is cheap.
What about now? Is it going down?
I mean, it's not loud.
Can you hear it now?
Yeah.
Or do you hear how low it is? You can hear it. The full volume.
Now,
it's not changed at all.
No.
Yeah, I turned it. Let me go back. And that was the bank truck. And see, at the beginning of this video,
turn the quality down. The picture's skipping.
Huh?
It's not showing the video. The quality. Turn the quality down. The picture's
it's
like
not
skipping.
Showing. How about now?
Yeah, it's halfway
playing?
Watching now. It's watchable now.
All right. Let me go back.
Oh shit.
No, but you see, he just got all that from the bank, right?
Right.
There's a reason they call it a dream. Who's there? Cock-a-doodle-doo, pal. No, 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 no! I don't have any more money!
My job sucks right now. Please, I'll have more money next month. You can't take my house.
Is that your signature?
Oh, okay, well, just tell me work something out, okay? I mean, you set up a credit guy, right? I mean, hey, wait! My dad is in there! No, don't take my dream! Oh, how did this happen? Pardon? Is that you?
Been a long time since both grade.
What the fuck are we watching, Square?
No need to concern. Just watched.
Stunned accomplishments. Let's get in. There's not much time.
I gotta go down back and get my life back. They took everything.
Oh, he's driving the DeLorean. You now.
Yeah. Look, extra set of balls. You're gonna need them.
You are. I'm here to show you how.
Shit's still skipping real bad.
One, First National Bank. What is a bank, you ask? A curious place where both space, time, and irony exist. And yet, don't.
Are you gonna be doing that the whole time?
Pay attention. Exhibit A, those who have come to deposit and safely store their earned monies. Exhibit B, those who need to borrow said money for purposes unknown.
Hey, that's me!
Ergo, Exhibit C.
It's like watching a reverse silent picture show. You got good sound, but shitty picture.
Such as you.
Hey, that's the guy! He took my house!
Really screwing my vibe here, Pi. Space-time continuum. He can't hear you. Just let me narrate. Where was I?
So you see, by the time he got to you, Pyle, his bank was out of money.
But he gave me lots of money and charged me a lot of interest.
Yes, that's the only way banks make money, by making debt loans. Debt equals money, Pyle. Remember that. Debt equals money. The more loans they make, the more money they make.
But if they don't have any money, then where'd my money come from?
You're gonna want to take a step back.
No. No way.
Yes way. And that's nothing.
Hey, buddy. Need some money?
They didn't do that.
Oh, they did exactly that, Pyle. Remember, banks make money by making loans, by selling debt, even to bad credit rates.
Yo, have some money, dude. Just sign here.
Oh my gosh.
They called it free money.
Yeah, that's exactly what free my money. Own guy told me. Free money.
But it ain't free. The worst power was offered.
We own your ass.
People power like you.
You're right. I didn't need him. I was happy here. I didn't need it. What's he saying? He's making all that money.
Shh. He's thinking. Now wait for it. Now wait for it. Bingo. See, the bank is loaned to everyone in town. But to make more money, they have to loan even more.
More? How much money do they need?
More.
More.
What's that?
No, a black horse riding.
Credit card.
Wow, look. I mean, it's gonna be okay. Everything's gonna be okay. What now?
Now, we're piling with all this money. We might as well party.
Oh, this is awesome! I needed to get my head clear. When I get back, I'm gonna straighten all this out. I just hope Dream is doing okay.
He said, "Bernanke."
I'm going to get you, my pretty.
See, it's Ben Bernanke as the wizard.
Yep, he is. I'm sure he is.
Yeah, you put it on his tab. It'll suck for yourself. Wait.
You know, wait a second, Herman. I just thought of something. If I got this money from the bank, and the bank got it from the Federal Reserve dump traps.
Go on.
Then where does the Federal Reserve get their money?
Real nice time, ladies. Real nice. Excuse me while I borrow you.
Say, Hartman, why am I wearing a burglar bikini top?
Because no one is allowed inside the Fed. Not you, not me, no American citizen, no duly elected member of our Congress, not the Supreme Court, not the
Supreme Court.
Not the Supreme Court, not the Justice Department, not the CIA, DIA, FBI, ATF.
That bitch is probably empty in real life.
Not even G-O-D.
Not even G-O-D. Wild
side. Government. The Fed is a private bank owned by private stockholders. Do not let the name Federal fool you. This plays about as federal as Federal Express.
A private bank? Private?
Best to keep your voice down, Bob.
This is Ethan, Federal Reserve.
Hey, Ethan. Bill here, First National.
Hi there, Bill. How are you?
Good, good. We're running a little low on money.
No problem. How much you need?
Oh, how does 20 million sound?
What?
Excellent. We'll ship it over first thing tomorrow.
Wait, he can just call up the Fed and ask for more money and they give him whatever they want?
No, pal. The Fed don't give the banks money. The Fed loans the banks money. The banks have to pay it back with interest. Now, come on, time to go.
Wait. I still don't understand. Where does the Fed get their money? I mean, if they're a private bank. You said they're a private bank, right? Okay, so who puts money into the Fed bank?
Our government.
This is Mel, United States Mint.
Hi, ML. First National needs another 20 millis.
We're already
That's
running
pretty
the
fucking accurate. Here,
gotta keep making loans, gotta keep the money flowing.
Now you see why I showed her this film.
You guys say 20 million more by morning.
But I don't get it. What's so wrong about the Fed printing money?
Because it's unconstitutional, Pop. Our treasury is supposed to create our money, but now the Fed controls the printing of America's money. Nobody gets a friggin' dollar that the Fed didn't print. So? They print the money, then they loan it to the government, then they charge the government interest, then the government taxes you to pay for it. Wake up, pal!
God, I don't see what the big deal is.
You know, you're right, pal.
Wait, I am?
Yeah. I forget how effective they are at keeping you ignorant.
Well, that's okay. Hey, I'm not ignorant.
Do you even know what money is, Pa? In the long, long ago, people bought it. They traded things they had for things they wanted. I'll trade you my raspberries for that there pot pie.
I don't want your berries.
Come on, sweet berries.
They're not sweet. They're old, and I don't like berries.
No. As you can see, this modern situation created some problems. Then one day, a goldsmith walked up and said,
"Now, everybody thinks gold is valuable, so why doesn't everybody trade gold for things they need?"
Damn, this is long.
Class was set for gold, and now it was very easy to conduct.
Not really. Because people it's like 30-something minutes.
All the things they needed.
Harvin! Wow, look at all my gold! Hey!
Damn!
Stop them! That's my gold!
Forgot about that.
Damn, thieves!
Say there, Pyle. I've got a vaulted cigar. I can keep your gold safe for you.
For a small fee.
Yeah, sure, that'd be awesome.
You see, Pyle, this is how the first banks made money.
There you go, Pyle. I owe you 100 gold coins.
Okay, great!
Come back anytime and redeem your gold when you want it. It'll be right here, in my vault.
Now you're holding the very first paper money pile.
Wow, this is great. It all makes sense.
Oh, that's right. It was good. Everybody started using IOUs because everybody knew the IOU was as good as gold.
Wow, this candy is really a good price. One IOU. I'm getting some more for later. Hey, wait a minute. It was just one IOU. 10 IOUs for chocolate? You can't just raise prices like that.
Oh, the Candyman can. Wait, that is just freaking wrong. It's called inflation. It makes your IOUs worth less and less until they are worth nothing. Less bang for the buck. Dollar ain't what it used to be.
But I worked hard and I baked all those pot pies. Now I have to work harder to make less? That's not fair.
Oh, if you think that's not fair, you're gonna love the next pot.
What's he doing?
How do banks make money, pal?
By making more loans.
Oh, that's right. He's good. See, he prints more IOUs without any more gold. Loans them out for interest, makes a pretty penny, and nobody is the wiser. Unless everybody wanted their gold back.
They're all Jewish.
No. That's my gold.
Not anymore.
What are you talking about?
I'd like to redeem my IOUs, please. Thank you very much.
Hey! I want my gold back now!
Thief! Thief! I love the bank run. Bringing people together.
Bringing people together.
Made a run of the bank and demanded their gold. As you can see, they ain't no gold to get.
Hartman!
Don't worry, Pop. Back in these towns, vengeance will be yours. Three things in this world you don't do. Never mess with another man's woman. Never mess with another man's ego. And most importantly, you will never mess with another man's money. Else, a man will mess with you.
My God! You hung him?
Yes, Pop. Oh, we hung him. We hung him high. And do you know why?
Because he was a thief?
Because, Pyle, an evil invention was born. Man discovered how to turn worthless paper into gold. Thus was invented the ultimate
House of Rothschild
to steal real money and enslave all the nations on Earth.
Oh, now, come on. You're just being dramatic. I mean, I lost my house, but...
What is that? Explain.
A nuclear power plant.
Mm-hmm. Produces lots of electricity and little pollution. An invention for the good of humanity.
Okay, but what's this have to do with...
3, 2... Holy atomic energy! A discovery more powerful than anything man had yet conceived. It can be used for good or evil. Now... Unlike Einstein, the goldsmith's discovery has been kept a closely guarded secret. It was never intended for you to see. This discovery is called fractional reserve banking. In the wrong hands, it's more powerful than the nuclear bomb in its ability to completely and utterly destroy a nation who is subjected to its perversion.
No.
It is time we stop this evil secret and the men behind it from being ridiculous, for America is destroyed forever. You need to leave it, Pop.
No. I just want my dog back.
That's it. I give up.
Poor guy just wants his gold back.
No. The tree of liberty must be refreshed from time to time with the blood of patriots and tyrants.
Thomas Jefferson?
Mr. President, how do I get him to understand? As we did, son, remain vigilant. Too many have hidden the truth, and the light of our liberty dims with every passing day. Quickly, take my horse. Show him.
Wait, show me what? Where are we going?
Stallion of Liberty! Right on the Holy Wind!
Oh, where are we?
Battle of Waterloo! Hold on, we gotta get
through. See there, he's saying Battle of Waterloo. There's there's the bank on the French side. And there's the bank on Britain's side.
A money machine. There it is. Hey, is that the same people? Rich banker men from Germany flying under the banner of the Red Sheet. They fought against both sides of the war. We must hurry. That's him, the Red Shield Cardia. Shoot him!
No, I'm not shooting anyone.
Damn it, Pop.
What?
He beat everyone back with the news of the war and told England that Napoleon.
This is getting boring, Square.
The Red Shield backers of London pretended that England was.
Maybe you.
Started selling their English stocks. The English went into a selling frenzy to get rid of worthless English money.
But
the English won, right?
Of course they won. It was a trick by Red Steel. They waited until the stocks plummeted in pennies and then fought England back for nearly nothing.
What did that? How?
When the English leaders found out, they had no choice to give themselves over to the Red Shield. Their money was gone and they were slaves to the Red Shield war debt. Since that time, the English have been paying the national taxes directly to the Red Shield private bankers. The people have no idea. The bankers bragged about what they did to us, laughing at us all the way to the bank.
Why, it's the best business I've ever done. If I control a nation's wealth, I cannot make its laws.
Oh, is this what Jefferson wanted to show me?
No, look. In
that's probably how it really is. One guy at the top with a lot of tentacles.
No, it's a horde of families.
Because Jefferson and the Patriots vowed to stop the evil tyrants at all costs. By authority, eternal God, he would not let the bankers win. To preserve our independence, we must not let our rulers load us with perpetual debt. We must make a choice between economy and liberty, or profusion and servitude.
Wow.
I place economy among the first and most important of republican virtues, and public debt as the greatest of the dangers to be feared. It is incumbent on every generation to pay its own debts as it goes.
We must have a central bank to sell this country's finances.
If the American people ever allow private banks to control the issue of their money, first by inflation and then by deflation, the banks and corporations that will grow up around them will deprive the people of property until their children will wake up homeless on the very continent their fathers conquered.
Jefferson, you're mad. This country will have a central bank.
Who's that? America's first Secretary of Treasury.
Alexander Hamilton?
Aaron Burr, Thomas Jefferson's vice president. They didn't take too kindly to our first Secretary of Treasury. Sweet shot. The first attempt at a central bank only lasted 20 years and was shut down. But the bankers tried again against old Hickory and Andrew Jackson.
You are a den of rappers and thieves.
I intend to rout you out, and by the eternal God, I will rout you out.
After
surviving an assassination attempt, Jackson finally defeated the bank in 1836. When asked what was the greatest accomplishment in his life, Old Hickory replied,
"I killed the bank."
And those were his last words. I killed the bank. And with real money backed with real gold, our country experienced the greatest boom in the nation's history. Oh, it was beautiful. But the bankers, greedy for more power and wealth, were concocting their most ambitious plan yet to once and for all take control of the finances of the United States. In 1910, a secret meeting was held at the J.P. Morgan estate on Jekyll Island off the coast of Georgia. This meeting was so secret, so concealed from government and public knowledge, that the 10 attendees used code names.
I am clearly the richest man, so I should be the one to run the super secret central bank. I own all the oil in America. I'm clearly richer than you will ever be, hula girl. I should run the super secret central bank. You're nothing compared to me, Loop Job. I shall run the secret bank.
Silence!
Supreme Master Lee, I didn't know you were gonna be here.
I'm not. Neither are you, dumbass.
Oh yeah, right. He's so smart.
None of you shall run the bank. We have failed in the past because of openness. This time, the key to success is secrecy. The people must believe that they...
How much longer is this?
Yes,
getting close.
A sneak attack. What's the plan?
We first create panic. Then we show them the solution. With our man in office and well-planned timing, we will have our central bank. And so the people think it is theirs. We shall christen it Federal. The Federal Reserve.
It struck on December 23rd, 1913. When most of our Congress were at home eating fruitcake, these bastards, bankers, presented their treasonous act to their newly elected accomplice, Woodrow Wilson, who had fortuitously already agreed to sign it before he was even elected. Wait, the IRS? I thought we always had the IRS. No, Pa. They did this to us, too. The Fed now has the exclusive power to print America's money. They loan this money to our banks and our government at interest, putting immediate debt on our own money, printing more and more, so each dollar they print becomes worth less than the one before. Merry Christmas. What in the hell is that? That part is how our government now must pay back these debts to the Fed. Your taxes did not go to your government. They don't? It's the greatest theft in human history. But, okay, I mean, I sort of get what you're saying, but it's also confusing and really hard, but I don't see how it affects me at all. If I had more money, none of this would have happened. '55? Wow, what are we doing here?
Oh, a little bit of shopping. Here, hold this. Got an S? 23 cents. Postage stamp? 3 cents. Ounce of gold? $35. Hot baby.
Prices.
Let's be getting back.
Fucking Michael.
Oh, was that Michael J?
Yeah, he'll be fine. Kapow! Would you agree that you have the same exact things you had in 1955?
Yeah, one stamp, 1 gallon of gas, 1 ounce of gold, and one home.
Wow, we just made a lot of money.
Gotta pay your taxes. Bet it's nice to have made all that money. Wait, that isn't fair. Now I actually have less money. I can't even go buy things I just sold.
The IRS and the Fed's inflation work together, Pyle. They aren't just taxing gain, they are taxing their inflation. You are no richer than you were in 1955. Now, does that sound fair or American to you?
Yeah, but I mean, who doesn't hate taxes? I hate the IRS anyway.
Pyle, the higher they make the inflation, the more your money they take. It's thievery. You're not paying taxes on anymore. You are paying taxes on the same, and now you have less. They take our property away right in front of our eyes, just like Thomas Jefferson said they would.
Bernanke.
What's that?
They found it. Quick, a sword.
What sword?
The banking machine. I condemn you to die. Damn it. Ah! Bernanke bogey on my knife. Take him at his knees.
For we are opposed around the world by a monolithic and ruthless conspiracy that relies primarily on covert means for expanding its sphere of influence.
What's happening? Where am I?
I believe perhaps you understand now, but you are afraid.
JFK. Hartman, what does this have to do with my house and my dog? Oh, okay, that's enough. I want to go home now.
This is the last president to stand up to the Fed. You must see. On June 4, 1963, President Kennedy signed Executive Order 11110.
My birthday.
This executive order empowered the U.S. Treasury to issue real money without the Fed. It would have worked. Kennedy's plan to dismantle the Federal Reserve machine had begun. 6 months later, John F. Kennedy went to Dallas and never returned.
No way. No way they could do that.
The new president, Lyndon Johnson, threw out Kennedy's order. Since JFK, no president has dared confront the secret powers behind the Federal Reserve. They consolidate bigger and bigger banks, print more and more money, accountable to no one,
decimating our nation's wealth for the benefit of a few. Why? Why do this? If they hurt us, it hurts the global bankers too. No, Pyle. They are protected. They are too big to fail. But I'm not. Those sons of bitches! Sons of bitches all. The day was cold. The wind sharp and strong.
Ah, damn.
But we were determined. The bankers and their parasites
sleep over here, square. Outnumbered,
but their hubris made
them. It's about over.
Not like us.
You can leave, I mean.
Not like this band of immortals we have assembled. We have come to take back our. Hardman? Is that. My dog. Oh, shit. Huh. It'd be inevitable. The Money Kings could ignore us no longer. They sent an emissary, a cog in their machine of greed to bring about our submission. Hank Paulson.
Hardman, this is blasphemy. We own the corners of the Earth. It is futile to challenge us.
Oh, I've seen that look before. That of a predator taking in the scent of its prey. Bold, fearless. The look of a free man.
You have come far, Hardman. Farther than most. Be smart now. Join us. We will bring you money, power, everything you want. You can be one of us. If you will kneel.
Miss Jefferson.
Madman. You're a madman. You're offering you everything. What do you think this is? This is America!
Yeah, it's a pretty good movie. That's how many years old now? 13 years old.
That's pretty funny.
Came out like
still relevant.
Yeah. Oh, Tekashi 6x9 got arrested 2 hours ago. Posted
again
for missing court date and speeding.
That's all paperwork.
Are you kidding me?
At a FTA on
he missed. He missing court date and speeding case. That's a low level warrant.
He's advocated for me. What do you mean? Your license and registration? I don't know which. Registration and license plate?
Still enough to get your hand up.
Registration.
Okay. But take this. License plate.
Just give me the registration.
He's got to know who he is.
Vehicle registration.
He was in the news not that long ago for one of them people found him at the gym.
Not insurance.
Yeah, they beat the fuck out of him, didn't they?
Facts.
He walked off. I'd say beating the fuck out. But you got to be down, have assistance or something. I mean, he was able to get up. He wasn't getting straight up. I mean, he was limping up.
Pictures I saw, he had a lot of lumps.
You say you don't have your driver's license?
No. You come to my house all the time. It's my Danny Hernandez.
Yeah.
Do you have the license on you? Or no?
You're like, I'm Daniel Hernandez, man. You know me. I helped the whole state of, what was it, New Jersey? I brought down my own crew, man. I'm the tourist.
D-A-N-I-E.
Fucking lucky he ain't been shot at. I mean, he really is. I mean, you know, nobody, you look at the culture that just hates, you know, I mean, I don't really know all about his case. All I know is the highlight. Supposedly, he cooperated so much that pretty much got a little pat on the wrist, and the rest of his people, they're the ones who got the hardcore sentences.
Yeah, all I know is a snitch.
Like, open in the courtroom snitching. Talking about, like, they made memes of his ass. He didn't try to... He took the stand and all for the camera. Like, if I was him, I'd be like, shit, I'll take the stand, but y'all got to keep them cameras up out that bitch. Yeah. I mean, if I was really him in that situation and going to go ahead and do that anyway, like, I mean, I would have tried to fight with more lever. Like, let me testify off stand or something. Like, I mean, I don't know why he didn't. No, I take that back. I think they actually did extend him witness protection, and he basically just fluffed his nose at it. Like, he didn't want it. Or he don't cooperate with it, but yeah, I'm sure he could be entitled to service. But if he don't want to, that ain't going to make him.
No, I have no idea.
That saves him money.
I don't know much.
But you got a Florida driver license?
Yeah, Florida driver.
Okay. So the address
that you hear.
No, I'm saying it's a Florida
DL.
It's gonna be
a Florida state.
Yeah.
Florida state
license. Yeah, it's gonna be a Florida
address. Okay. Yeah, you can't have a state ID with an out of state address or driver license or anything.
Step out of the car, sir.
Because that's basically how you establish residency somewhere. When you go somewhere, you're technically supposed to change your tag and your license in 30 days. I had an argument with the cops when I was in high school in Nashville because I had a Missouri ID, but I was going to change it to Tennessee, obviously. I had to do that. But my car was registered to my granddad as my birthday gift. So, and I remember being on campus, and when they would circle, do random searches. I remember they told this one guy, Josh, that was in our class. He was like, no, he was pretty like well off. And anyways, he big hair dude, like hippie type, like hair and smoke. Like they knew he smoked weed. And I remember they searched him one day, and they was like, we find one seed, you're going to jail. You know. That was bad, you know, and shit, it'd still be like that. Tennessee still ain't legalized or nothing, even medically. So it's still the same way it was when I went to school.
Nashville's and, getting relaxed about it.
Well, technically, it's sort of decriminalized at low levels, but if you get pulled over and you got like 28 grams or more, I guarantee you, you're getting fined. If not,
yeah, they're going to blow you over.
No, they're probably going to take you down and you're going to be cited and released is what will happen. Like,
yeah, and
when I was there, they got behind my car one day, you know, because basically how the cops did it was they would look out for things. And I had a Kurdish friend. Depending on the day, could one to two, maybe all three, my friend in the back. Well, no, two, no, I'll tell you the record. So it was Resgar, Jam, Darius, and then Muhammad, maybe sometimes Keenan, which Muhammad was Kurdish as well. Keenan's the person that got shot. It ran with the same people Scooter did or does, whatever, that I told him about that got shot in Nashville. He was one of my best friends. And his granddad was a mason. And and, you know, mine was too. And I remember him showing me a Bible and some stuff. And that's when I first got my interest in masonry too, was when I was in high school, like 9th, 10th grade. I even tried looking to join and everything, but, you know, in Tennessee, you had to be 21, and in Missouri, it was 18. So my plan was whenever I came back home, I was going to join. And once I became, and that's exactly what I did. I joined when I was 19. So anyways, he got behind my car, and I think it was just the usual people. And, you know, he's looking at that. All right, you know, and he's seeing all these different, and both the cops are white, you know, I don't know if they was profiling like that or whatever, but for some reason, like, they got behind my car, I'm a little geeky, maybe looking kid, and then you got some of these guys that, yeah, they may look a little rough, like, around the edges, and then Muhammad, you know, he was not rough. Rezgar was, he was a chameleon, like, he worked and always made sure to have an image put on in front of his parents, but, like, you know, he smoked and everything. I think they knew he smoked, too, but they just, you know, he's still, his family was heavy, really religious and stuff, so he didn't flaunt it or anything, you know, he had to hide it. So, and so was Muhammad, too. So, anyways, we got into an argument, me and the cop did, because he'd said, like, that's not going to work. He was sitting there looking at my car and saying, talking this shit. And I knew he was talking to me. And I was like, what do you mean that's not going to work? What are you talking about? He said, your license plate. He said, you got to get that changed. I said, tell me how I'm going to do that. He said, you got to take it down and change the registry. I said, it's not mine. I was like, he's like, well, whose is it? I said, it's my grandpa. And he's like, your grandpa lives in Tennessee? No. He lives in Missouri. He's not moving anytime soon either. And this is his car he's letting me use. I was like, so you're right. I got to change my license maybe, but I don't have to change this tag. He's like, yeah, that ain't going to work. And he still told me, he said, no, that ain't going to work. He said, you're not going to have a Tennessee license and drive. I was like, it's not against the law. I was like, you come back. I was like, I'll come back to school tomorrow. And you bring the law book or whatever, bud, since we're in the school setting. That's exactly how I told him. I said, you bring me the law shows I can't do that. And I promise you, I will get it changed to my dad's name or whatever. But my granddad's not under any force to have to do that. Like, it's not required. There's no law that says you can't let someone. Hell, rental cars are licensed in the state you get them from. But all they right. can be taken across states and used for as long as you need them. All they have to have is insurance and a valid registration. So I thought it was funny that I knew, you know, like even back then I was getting in arguments with cops and stuff. And, you know, that's why I think it's weak that the work you've heard, because, I mean, I got a small department. The department is fucking crap. You know what our department is offering cops right now? $24 an hour. Because we lost five all at one time. It's like almost double or a third more, almost double maybe, than the town just 5 miles away. And I saw somebody on Facebook talking to the cops on there in the town, because in the town over, that's where I used to always hang out at. I never had any problems with the police there. Never. And that's Crothersville. All my friends lived in Crothersville mostly. So I was always over there. But they were like, somebody was telling one of the cops on there, he's like, y'all about to go to Hayti, ain't you? Because the sheriffs have been having to patrol here. And like the last time I had to deal with them, the sheriff was sent out here. That's because my granddad had been gone for quite a while. I was worried about him. Didn't make sense how he was gone. Yeah. But he just happened to be somewhere where I didn't know. But yeah, when he came out here, I was like, they still ain't got no replacement officers. He said, nope. He said, yeah. He said, we're originally just supposed to you know, expected to maybe be helping out for a little bit, and they had to extend it or whatever. They had to,
yeah, they only make like, they only make like 18, 19 bucks an hour here.
Now they're offering them 24 because I mean, they're desperate as shit. The chief is,
I bet.
We still got the same chief, but the officer that originally led and said that I wasn't going to be prosecuted for the accident that ended up prosecuting me later, he was the one that tried to get me on, end up on the DUI charge when I was parked in my driveway, and it dropped. And I think he was still sour about that. And when I had that accident that day and he was sent out here, I was completely honest with him, you know, and up front. He is like, if anything, the most, he said, I think it would be a discharge in the city limits. And he said, and you might, he said, you for sure will have to pay for any of the damage and stuff.
Yeah.
And I said, okay. But, and so, and then 30 days later, boom, they came back with a subpoena to appear in court.
Damn.
With a chart. Yeah. But the thing is, he did the same thing he didn't do, though, on the DWI arrest. Not, and I wasn't fucked up, but it's the thing. When I was at my house, technically, by the definition, with my keys being on me, but the car not being on, he was trying to argue that merited operating motor vehicle. Like he explained, he broke it down because I was like, "How the fuck am I operating it?"
He said, just sitting there.
He said, "You're readily able to operate it." He said, "If the keys are in your possession and you're actively intoxicated, and especially near the vehicle," he said, "which you were sitting in it when I first came up." I was like, "Yeah, I was sitting in it, but I hadn't left." I was like, "I've been home for hours." I was like, "I worked in Memphis." I was like, it was my car was backed in the driveway. Like I had not just pulled in or anything. It was stationary. There wasn't any fresh water underneath it. I said, you want to get in and move it and look underneath it? I'm telling you, like, I have not. He's like, I know. He's like, I know you. Like he admitted that he knew I hadn't been driving. And not only that, he never requested a drug test, a blood test, nothing. Breathalyzer, not a damn thing. And then he lied and said he was a DRE. He said he was a DRE. And my attorney said, no, he's not. He said he let his certification lapse about over a year ago. He's like, so, yeah. He's like, I'll eat this up. And he did. Yeah, he ate it up. So I think that dude was still fucking. But he's not here no more now. So thank God for that. And he's the same fucking cop. No, he's not. No, it's a different cop. There's another cop that had my same last name that dealt with the issue whenever that girl had fucked around her husband. And her husband did all that bullshit and like, you know, abused her, threatened her. And,
yeah, I remember.
Yeah, that's the only cop that's ever. That I've ever come across in this city in all my time being here that actually did their job. Like, I had been, number one, I've been put in a fucked up situation because somebody decided to, oh, I'm going to talk to somebody, but I'm going to hide my marriage type bullshit and say that we're separated and whatnot. Hold on a second. Testing. Yeah, I had to change microphones. Okay, so you know, like he, because he was interrogating me, and you know, that was probably like the first time I'd been like interrogated like that.
Right.
And I had dealt with cops and had bad experiences with them. I'd seen the YouTube lecture, "Don't Talk to Police," and all that.
So I was trying to cooperate, but at the same time, I wasn't, you know, it was 11 o'clock at night. They weren't telling me what the fuck I was there for. They're asking me these roundabout questions. I knew they were skimming for something, but I don't, like, I was wondering what in the fuck could they possibly be trying to skim for? And then when they started asking the more specific questions, I was like, I couldn't, I was blank. I was like, and so then I started like wondering, is she, you know, my mind really thought, like, is this person fucking missing or dead? That's right where it went. And I mean, like me, you know, seems crazy, but craziest shit has happened. That's where my mind went, you know, because I'm, number one, I'm always into true crime and stuff. I think that was one of the major reasons. And plus, it wasn't until they got to, well, were they at your, you know, you've been with them and stuff, have y'all been intimate? When they started asking, as soon as he asked, had we been intimate, I was like, yeah. I was like, well, I was like, what's that got to do with it? I was like, fling. He's like, what do you, he's like, relationship, talking. Like, that was his next question. I was like, it was one time, literally. He said it was just one time. I was like, yeah. And he said, okay. And I was like, what is this about? Like, I think I probably asked that question about 50 times. And he kept saying, oh, I'm getting to it. He's like, well, there's been an allegation that you, and I was like, excuse me? And he said, there's been an allegation that you, and I said, that's no. And he said, well, he said, look, he said, I don't know you really. He's like, you know, I'm not from here. He said, but I think I dealt with him once for get pulled over one time. But he's like, you don't stand out or strike me. You know, of course, I was thinking, you know, shit, he might just be lying to me. You know how they can lie.
Yeah.
And so I started freaking out. I was like, okay. I was like, she came over at 11 o'clock in the morning. I was like, I didn't get her fucked up or nothing. I was like, I don't see. He's like, and he didn't have anything to say to that. Like, he didn't say, well, that's not what she said. Or she said that you, you know, like, threatened her. He didn't ever say anything like that. He just took me in. It wasn't until after the next morning that I got released and nothing was filed that she called and I had sent it to him. Because I was like, I've been told by the person who alleged this stuff, I straight up called him immediately. I was like, no, I've been told by the person that alleged this stuff that she was forced to do it by her husband, and that when she actually came and told you in the car, she threw up in your car because she was drunk. I was like, is that true? He's like, I didn't know she was drunk. I was like, man, bullshit. I was like, well, I've got it all on the phone recorded. He's like, well, send it to me. I was like, no problem. Brownie, he ain't acting like it. You want to go outside? He hadn't acted like it at all. I don't even think he went. He didn't even go when we were gone all day today. Brownie, sit. We took him with us. Like, I took him outside. He never went. Pretty much.
Okay. Hey, your hoodie may be dry and dark.
Yeah, I'll get it out. Should be after I put it in there. Why? No, they're not. They're, I didn't. No, I'll get them. I'll get it. Don't worry about it.
Hey, I've got something out there.
What?
Sitting there on a campsite show is a little hard thing, right? I
Oh. Did it go through the wash? It's a coil from my vaporizer. It might be okay. I took that in case I needed to change it. Thought I was getting close to needing to change the coil. No, I don't know where these people. But yeah, I don't want any questions that have to do with, like, I'll talk about Browning maybe and stuff. I ain't answering no questions that got anything to do with anything else. So don't nobody need to even bother asking them.
I haven't asked you any questions.
No, I'm just saying in general because I ain't looked at the chat or nothing, but I know that MC and them fish about it and other people in roundabout ways. I gave anybody my cell phone number, so ain't nobody can betray me on that for money. Cause y'all some broke motherfuckers out here selling phone numbers for $100. Like Red Eye had to have done that. If I don't even think he would have gave it to Fusion, or Fusion would have paid him $100. I really don't think he would have. Maybe 50. Not 100. I just don't know.
Give me one second, Square.
It makes sense why he tried. Why he did that Gene shit. He tried to make me think that Gene done it. He didn't want Gene to, he didn't want me and Gene to be friends at all.
All right, I'm back.
One for what?
Oh, yeah. She bet you she knows who that is. She like, I'm arresting 6ix9ine today.
Tell me for what, though? Yeah, I'm going to take
him. She's like, yeah, I'm going to take him. I'm getting this one.
You got a traffic warrant.
Traffic warrant.
You for a traffic warrant?
Yeah, you appear, bro. You didn't show up before.
I didn't know that.
Went
for what though?
Yeah. Hell yeah. I didn't know. You don't have enough. I don't know excuse on the FTA.
Did you see the ticket or something? You didn't pay? I never see a ticket. Step 4 for me. Go run.
If you got a ticket and you didn't pay it, then you have to go to court.
That's usually how it works.
Yeah, you got
a traffic warrant, so you're going to be going to the County Jail. You want to leave your property with your peoples, or are you going to take it with you?
Yeah, I'm not. Right. Y'all right.
Do you have anything on you that you can set up?
What happened?
Any weapon in there?
It's out for a traffic warrant. You hear this?
Damn. Damn, it's a lot, buddy. To have on you.
You'll give that to Yailin? Just take it back home.
Okay.
That's stupid having that much cash on you. You know the government can fucking just take that under suspicion. It's called civil asset forfeiture. If you get a bad cop, or even a cop that's not bad but believes you're involved in something, and you get pulled over anything over $10,000.
Yeah, they'll try to take every bit of that shit.
They did with a veteran.
Yeah, I've seen that.
Traveling. A veteran was traveling, and he got pulled over, and he said, that's my entire life savings. And he's like, well, I'm part of the interdiction unit, and I believe it's, he's like, I'm a veteran. He's like, I just, you know, he, matter of fact, let me find that.
Right. They're not nothing but a big giant gang. That's all they are. A gang with badges.
And the dude's real patient for somebody that's having his savings and money, all his money. Like, I don't even think he had the money to finish his trip after this. Nevada. I ain't been out in Nevada since I was a kid.
That's what Cecilia, Officer Brown, I mean, you
taking money out of
McKinney. I've always wanted to go out west.
Are you taking food out of McKinney?
Like I said, we believe right now that this is run from this currency.
Well, I'm going to prove to you that it's not.
Perfect.
It's supposed to be that way, though. You ain't supposed to have to prove. He's supposed to have to prove, or have, you know, that's, well, that's
you're guilty until you're proven innocent.
Exactly. In this case, that's
that
exactly
clip shows
what
a retired U.S. Marine being robbed of his life savings on the side of a highway.
Highway
arrested
robbery.
For, charged 100%. With, or convicted of any crime. He wasn't even ticketed. This is a rare glimpse into an abuse
ticket.
Of power that thousands of innocent Americans experience each year. Through a public records request,
well, to be honest, he gave him a ticket. That'd almost be like a kick in the balls. Insult to injury. They'd already taken
$110,000. The Institute for Justice was able to acquire body and dash cam footage of an entire roadside seizure, from the initial traffic stop to the seized money being deposited at the bank. This is the most complete footage.
They took it straight to the bank.
On February 19, 2021, our client Stephen.
That's interesting. They don't take it to a lab and, like,
right.
You know, because they can, you know, they say that bills have a little percent of residue. Why not they take it to a lab? I mean, if it's drug money and it's been handled around the movement of drugs, that shit should have more than just trace amounts on it, you know, like.
Was pulled over outside of Reno by the Nevada Highway Patrol.
And they do it under the DEA some DEA authority or some shit, I think. So if it's directly related to drugs, which it is 9 out of 10 times, then why don't they ever examine the money?
Visit his daughters in a small California town just west of Reno.
That cop took it straight from the fucking car to the bank. So he's followed too closely right now.
Driving under the speed limit.
Ooh. Gonna stop him. Make sure. Oh.
Yeah, you know, initially I thought I was getting pulled over because maybe I.
Square, I'm gonna jump down, man. I'm gonna go get a shower. If you're still alive in a little bit, I'll jump back up.
And that was necessary to
get
a car
will be.
For a short duration for that weekend. Yeah.
I'm doing great. Hey, the reason I'm stopping you with a special enforcement campaign going on, we're trying to educate drivers about violations they may not realize they're committing, but we're seeing a big increase in crashes out here. First, apologize on your driving.
And look, I go down here, I swear, the comments are bad or anything, I will straight up turn these motherfuckers off. Yeah, that's the whole point. And for these people, like Kyle and them, to lie and say that it was true when I was cleared by a fucking investigation. Well, not really an investigation. Hell, before then, I got ahead and started before they really did on their investigation any deeper. Like, yeah, they had taken buccal swabs of me or whatever, but that was just routine because... I don't even think she got an exam or whatever. Like, I believe she told me she didn't. Yeah. Because look, after that happened, I got evidence out the wazoo. Like, I kept documenting all of this just in case, you know, backed up the recorded call, still have it backed up to this day on drives and cloud and everything. She kept trying to pursue shit with me after. And I was like, no fucking way. No. I was like, no. I mean, she was throwing herself on me, like sending me flowers, like a bouquet of flowers and different stuff sometimes. Like one time I literally told them, I don't want to accept it. I was like, so if you guys want to keep the money and say I just like tell her I didn't accept it if she asked. I was like, I don't, because I mean, I literally had the same person delivering me the shit. And I was like, this has got to stop, seriously. And I didn't even want to let her in on everything, but I being how I am, I talked to the lady one day and I was like, I was like, this girl fucking came to me, right? Talked to me, said she wasn't with her, you know, all that, and then that. And then the very next day, I vindicated, get the truth. And then I go through that, and then here she is afterwards, and she's still trying to, and I don't want anything to do with her. She is like, yeah. She's like, I knew something was weird when you kept coming. She's like, when I was like, yeah. I was like, I didn't even know this was a thing. Like, I used to buy girls flowers and stuff that I took for prom and things. I even did it for people I dated. I did it for Kayla. I did it for Brandy. I was like, I never had it done for me. The only thing I had done was when I was in the hospital, Brandy had brought me like a little thing from the gift shop or whatever. That's it.
You drive great. You're driving really slow. It appears that you're driving, trying to drive safely under the speed limit. I appreciate that. I just want to talk about your following distance, especially around commercial vehicles.
The highway patrol officer seems friendly and reasonable at first, even complimenting Stephen's driving. He orders Stephen to exit his vehicle and starts asking him a series of questions.
He uses driving to pull him over, though.
Please often ask questions like this to see if a suspect's story lines up.
You a fighter? Yeah, you got a tap-out shirt on. Well, I've got a lot of training. I'm a retired Marine.
What do your daughters do, man?
Ever been in trouble with law enforcement before?
When did you leave? Where did you leave?
What part of Texas are you thinking of buying a house in? What were you doing for work up there?
The officer then explains the real reason he pulled Stephen over.
Hey, while I'm working on this, let me ask you something. It's going to sound kind of weird. Part of my job out here, I do what's called highway interdiction.
Here it goes.
I look for people that are smuggling contraband through our state, across the country, weapons, humans, drugs, illicit currency, things like that. Anything in the vehicle I should be aware of?
Last thing he asked, illicit currency.
Okay. No firearms? No explosives? Okay. Are there any drugs in the vehicle? Cocaine? Yeah, I gotta ask all these silly questions, right? Okay. Any large amounts of United States currency in the vehicle? Okay. What's a large amount of U.S. currency to you?
Damn, my live is really fucking... Okay. Damn, I don't like that.
So there's over 10,000 in there? Okay. How much money you got in there? Okay. Well, fair enough. Fair enough. Would you give me permission to search your vehicle today?
Fair enough.
That's okay with you? Okay, perfect.
Oh yeah, this is horrible. All right. Well, I'm going to let y'all listen to the rest of this. There's no need in me showing it. It's god fucking awful.
Although it's Steven's right to refuse, he gives the officer permission to search his car.
I didn't want to come across as being non-cooperative or combative. So I did what I felt was right, and I was very honest, very forthcoming. I was also very respectful. And I just wanted to make their job as easy as possible so that I could be on my way to spend time with my children.
Hey, Shane, how are you? Good. Hey, can you head out to a traffic stop? Are you busy on that other stuff? Okay. Hey, so far, I'm still searching a car, but a big bundle of money says probably at least $100,000.
That interaction shows what's at the heart of the officer's interest in Stephen. He knows that even if Stephen did nothing wrong, the DEA will adopt the seizure of his cash and return a portion of the money to the highway patrol for the favor of giving them the case. Here's how an adoption works. When state or local police seize cash, cars, or other property, federal law enforcement takes over the forfeiture. The federal agency does all the work and kicks back up to 80% of the proceeds to the state agency that seized the property. In Stephen's case, that would mean the DEA would take control of the cash and seek to forfeit it through federal law, ignoring the important limitations that Nevada law places on seizures and forfeitures. In 2019 alone, federal agencies made $334 million in equitable sharing payments to state and local law enforcement agencies. In this case, the Nevada Highway Patrol stands to gain nearly...
V is for what are you talking about? I'll tell you what. Here. I will drop the link, let you come up, and I'll end the live. And then we can talk privately, because I'm not handing out my number, and you're coming at me weird. It's the only option I got. Other than if you want to email me or something. Well, you can speak to me privately. Just join the link and I'll end the broadcast. Nobody will see it. Unless, of course, you let them see it. All right, hold on a second. Bye-bye, Prine Eyes.